Are you looking for a five-star read? Are you looking for an award-winning read? Are you looking for a book that has been critically acclaimed by readers and book lovers and reviewers all over the world? If the answer to any of these questions is yes, then my friends, you've come to the right video. Hey guys, I'm Sankalpita and you are watching bookGeeks India. In this video, I bring to you the book review of this book, Jasmine Days by Benyamin. Now, this is a very famous book and this was also my first read for November, which I actually read before Diwali when I had lots and lots of things to do. But this got me so engrossed that I actually ended up, you know, finishing it just like that, very, very quickly. Now, before I start with the review, I want to tell you a little bit about the book itself, about the author and about the translator. So let's start with the book. The book was first published in 2014 in Malayalam and it was called Malappu Niramulla Pakalukal. Now, I obviously know that I'm saying it wrong, but I just wanted to learn it. Malappu Niramulla Pakalukal. Right. Wrong. I don't know. So this book was later translated into English by this woman called Shahnaz Habib. And towards the middle of this year, this book was longlisted and then shortlisted for the JCB Prize of Literature. And finally, it ended up winning the inaugural JCB Prize for Literature of 2018. Moving on to something about the author. So this author is called Benyamin and this is actually his pen name. His real name is different. So this book is actually his second book. The first one was published in 2008 and it was called Adu Jivitam, which was in Malayalam. It was later translated into English as Goat Days. Now, he's a really popular author because his books have been translated into many languages. He has written 20 books as of now. So Benjamin was born in 1971 and he was born and raised in Kerala. He later shifted to this Middle East country of Bahrain. So after having worked there for a couple of years, he later shifted back to Kerala in 2013, 2 years after the Arab Spring Revolution. Now, why I talk to you about Arab Spring is because this particular revolution is one of the major themes of this book. In fact, it is not one of the, but the one major theme of this book. Shahnaz Habib was born and brought up in Kerala. She later moved to New York in the United States of America. She's currently a consultant for the United Nations and she also teaches writing at New School and Bay Path University. So here, as you can see, the book has a gorgeous cover. It's a hardbound edition. If I take off the jacket, this is how it looks. And I don't know if you can see, but yeah, it has a comfortable font size. So overall, the ease of readability for this book is good and the quality of the paper is also very, very good. As a reviewer, I always tell you what to expect from a given book. So in this book, you can expect a lot of drama, all kinds of drama like family drama, emotional drama. And because this book has a socio-political event, so you can also expect a lot of socio-political drama. So Jasmine Days is the story of this young Pakistani woman who moves from Pakistan to this Middle Eastern city, and the city's name is actually not given in the book. So now Sameera Parvin has moved into this Middle Eastern city and she's obviously looking for employment. She already has a lot of relatives staying in this city, including her own Baba and a lot of family members like Tayaji's and Taiji's and their cousins. So basically it's a huge family. Initially it takes her a little time to adjust to this new city, this newfound freedom, this newfound money. But yes, slowly and steadily she starts getting used to this life and she starts enjoying it. But all her dreams about making it big in this city and making this city her home are turned into dust when the Arab Revolution of 2011 crops up. So basically a lot of socio-political issues are being brought to the front. A lot of revolutionary ideas are gaining fervor and there is this kind of unrest in the society which will soon turn into a full-fledged revolution. So how that revolution changes Sameera's life and the lives of every other person that she knows is what is the story of this book, and I think it's a fantastic read. Something interesting that I would like to tell you about the book. So when you read this book, it appears that it is actually Sameera's story, which she's writing in a diary, and which through a complex exchange of hands later comes into the hands of Benyamin, who decides to write it as a full-fledged novel. So what all is fact and what all is fiction? There's actually no way of knowing it. So this kind of style of writing a novel is called the Flaubertian style, and it's actually made use of by a lot of authors who want to give their book a pseudo-realistic kind of appeal, like, you know, confuse the reader whether it is actually fact or fiction. I think the author has done a brilliant job of creating these characters, which tell you such diverse perspectives about various people. So most of the characters, and there are a lot of characters in this book, so basically all these characters come from diverse backgrounds. They are Sunnis, they are Shias, they are rich, they are poor, they are the ruler and the ruled, they are the migrant and the citizens, they are from India, they are from Pakistan, they are from other Middle Eastern countries. So we get a lot of perspectives, and that's a really good thing, because in the end, if the book teaches you anything, it is that humanity survives no matter what. And above all our differences as humans, it is humanity that matters the most. Coming to the writing style of the author, as I already told you, the author uses this technique called Flaubertian realism, which actually confuses the reader as to how much of the book is actually fiction or fact. And I absolutely loved it because it brings a kind of complexity to the story, which was very new to me because I have not read any such books before. Another thing that I liked about the book is that it relies a lot on the emotional appeal of the characters to the reader. A migrant Pakistani girl learning to live and work in an environment where there are a lot of Indians also. So her entire workplace has a lot of Indians, and there's always this tug of war between India and Pakistan, and she is always, you know, left lonely. And then again, there is this concept of being uprooted from your own country and put into an entirely different environment, different city, and coming to terms with it and learning to live with the hostility that sometimes, you know, comes with it. So these are certain emotional appeals which the characters and the authors relies heavily upon. As you guys already know, this book was shortlisted for the JCB Prize for Literature. I decided to try and read all the 6 books that were shortlisted. And the very first book that I read, All the Lives We Never Lived by Anuradha Roy, was a brilliant read. So I had that kind of an image in mind when I sat down to read this book also. And then because this book won the prize, so I was expecting a lot from it. But then when I actually read this book, I realized that it's not so much about writing in this book. The writing is rather plain and simple. It doesn't have that kind of richness or eloquence or melody to it as, you know, All the Lives We Never Lived had. So I think it was basically the problem of high expectations that somehow disappointed me a little. So I'm a huge history buff, and if you've been following my channel, you know that I love, absolutely love history. So when I was reading this book, I came across a lot of information about Middle East, contemporary Middle East, and the Arab Spring of 2011, the revolution that happened in those days. So of course, I read a lot about it. I did a lot of background research. I googled every single piece of information that I came across in this book. So yes, it gave me a lot of exposure, and I absolutely loved it. Moving on to the climax of this book. So the climax of Jasmine Days is not as appealing as the book itself. It does have some issues, but yes, it gave a satisfactory end to the story. Another thing that you learn at the end of this book is that there's another book which is coming in 2019, which is called, just a second, Al Arabian Novel Factory. And these two books, Jasmine Days and Al Arabian Novel Factory, are actually hailed as twin novels. So I don't know the concept of twin novels. Obviously, I have to look it up. So yes, all you need to know is that there is another novel coming, and obviously I am excited about it. So when it comes to Jasmine Days, there is no dearth of entertainment. There are so many characters, so many plot subplots to keep you invested. And you know, the characters easily appeal to you. You easily get invested in their lives and what is happening in and around them. And because this also has a real political backdrop, so it is all the more interesting. So yes, when it comes to entertainment, I gave this book 5 stars because I absolutely could not put it down until I got to the end of it. 5 reasons to give you to pick this book up. So pick this book up if you're looking for a 5-star entertaining read. Pick this book up if you're looking for an award-winning Indian literature. Pick this book up if you really like translated regional literature. Pick this book up if you're looking to learn about the Arab Revolution of 2011. And finally, pick this book up if you want to learn about the life of a migrant in a Middle Eastern city. The only reason that I would give you to not pick this book up is if you don't like social political dramas, because this book has a lot of it and it also has a part of political history. So if that is not your thing, then definitely don't go for this book. And apart from that, I don't think there's any other reason you should not read this book. So that's it from me in this video, guys. This was the book review of Jasmine Days by Benyamin. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit that like. Also, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Share this video with your friends and family. And also, please do comment about what are you reading currently. I'm currently reading a book which is called The Diary of an Incurable Romantic by Chitrangada Mukherjee. And it's turning out to be a really good read. So what are you reading currently? Let me know in the comments below. And I will see you pretty soon in the next video. Until then, bye.